for that 1 minute.
Deep stuff.
For that 1 minute.
Go to the border to Canada when Trump gets elected.
That's not deep. That's obvious.
That's actually kind of basic. That's basic sort of stuff, actually.
That's going on at that as well.
Is there really like a... That's actually really cool. I like this, but the same time I'm like, no, I don't want that because I can't cast directly from the window.
Stop.
Hey, you guys! Welcome here to Season 5 of the Mummified, and for the first time ever, Smooth Sailing!
Huh?
I want to give a good shout out to my good friends over at Everfree Northwest, who are going to be giving this wonderful con at 10 a.m. on a Sunday. I hate you guys!
Hey,
okay,
you
want
to give me your panel title? Because I won the panel in...
Anyway, so yeah, thank you everybody for joining us here at Everfree Northwest. How are y'all having a good time for this weekend, right? I want to die because I had an MC last night.
Yes.
It felt good, but I don't. Anyway, so I probably should think
that it's just mummified, it's not lying, it just doesn't say it.
It's not, it's just not 100% truthful. Anyway, Chadwick, welcome to the panel, guys, obviously, most of you. Who watches our show? Good.
Don't be lying, Storm. You're only on episode 15, man.
Yeah. He's on episode 15. By the way, okay, for those of you who don't know, we are... Wait,
need to remind myself of what's next. Okay, yeah, no.
Okay, so for those of you who don't know who we are, what our show is about, I'm the host, and he's the show editor, Smooth Sailing, who, we're on a podcast called Living Sucks. We review Pony OCs and constructive criticism. Two people who are looking for it. We don't go out and just grab random people's OCs. We actually sit there and take a look, and they come to us and say, hey, how can I make my clone better? What's good about my clone? What can I do with it? Sometimes it's like, narcissism is just like, talk about my art. I just want to do that. Just put it on your shelf. Talk about how great my art is. I don't care what you said. Just talk about me. I'm like, alright, well.
Okay.
As much as I like talking about myself, yeah, I'll talk about some of that. Anyway, so yeah, we give constructive criticism to 8 ponies in a photo, or try to 8 ponies in a photo. 4 good, 4 bad. Each one of them has been shown brings on the good and bad, and we review them and result on who's best and who's worst closely. Yeah, unless we're smooth and bring on 2 good ones. Hey, Zish. No, I told Smooth to wake you up. Smooth, do you remember the video of Zish?
She's sleepy.
That's why you need to wake up somebody when they're asleep.
She was asleep, though. I was like,
Zish, I love you so much. I feel so bad about not waking you up. Like,
congratulations, you're on the panel.
Yeah. I tell you that Smooth, he failed me just like so many times in the past. For the last time! That's not something you should tell me. What? Where's my panel? Hey guys, where's my panel?
What's my panel?
That's Everfree 1 and 2. It's up the first set of stairs on the Starbucks.
You go up, you go by.
Go up the stairs by the Starbucks. Go up the tunnel. I don't know, ask one of the people in the Chiefs shirts. No, you sit down.
Is that the college?
I'm actually on the phone right now. I can't tell. It's just started at 10 o'clock. Oh, yeah. Yeah. Sorry. There you go. I got to tell them. Love you, love you. Anyway, so. Yeah, normally I would be something. It's cheap. Anyway, sorry. Completely rude thing. Anyway, first show, podcast, what kind of life is this? We're going on to the more important matter at hand of what we're doing right now.
It's more important than my favorite and subscribing.
Anyway, so, yeah, we're going to be talking about OCs. Some of you who just, I don't even know what to put it, calling you to the distance. I'm just, we're going to go to the sirens call, and we're just like, ooh, you don't know what an OC is. So it's like, okay, if you don't know what an OC is, what's an OC? It is a original character. Original character. Or other character. That's dumb. Use that term. Stop. That's like saying, hey, you can make a facial position. You can make a commit. Or you can call a fan character, which is even worse. That's like, look, hey, you know what, I need a handful of shrunken glass on the nose? Don't forget. And then it's like, it boils down to a character who lives in a fictional world, possibly sometimes living within the canon of an already existing world, or some other, like, new world that you maybe find yourself in. So some random world that you're living in. Sometimes that can be in fictional worlds like Harry Potter, or Anime World, or in this kind of defense of this Sonic OC thing, it actually was really cool. Like, I had to search hard to actually find a good Sonic OC. And I'm actually quite happy about it.
Yeah,
I don't know. I'm Dave the Hedgehog. I like tacos.
No, they didn't.
Don't care. No, they didn't. It's my panel. I say there are no good red and black characters. If that's your starting thing, you're not going well. You're just no. He's not good. Anyway, so continuing on with the it could be a soda, or short for personification. That's one of the big old college words, right? Donald Trump. Anyway, it's an avatar for you to, like, live in the world that it is this fictional area, for you to, like, project yourself into it. A, you can make a show character, which is sort of like a different thing. It's a character you name, but it's not supposed to be you, though it could still be an avatar, if I can get the really cozy, her, like, sunny, whatever, OC. Is it her, but we all know that that's her, but it's not actually her, it's just an avatar. Whatever, it's not her personified, it's just a character. And then obviously we have another category. Because not everything can be grouped into two categories. It can't just be good or bad, it's just new. Not on our show, it's all good. Anyway, next. Oh, yeah, right, because you guys know what this is. You didn't just wander in here because, hey, I don't know what this guy is.
It's only with things.
You know what I'll see from it. You know who we are. You're going to be like, it doesn't matter who you are, because Mummified has come back to Seattle. You're watching too much wrestling. It's bad. It's a terrible thing.
Get out, Medi.
No. Hold on, leave me Medi. Oh, the company is ruining everything. They don't know how to write characters. They don't know how to do this. And the wrestling is bad. Why would they ever fight this person? It doesn't make sense.
And like, why do you keep watching them?
Yeah, Medi. You've been one guy that, like, he'll talk about how much he loves something, and they'd be like, it's the worst thing ever. I don't like it. Anyway, sorry, back to the panel. You have to keep me on track, because I will... Anyway, so, this is a lovely chart that I found on Tumblr one day. I think you guys did Lucid Dream or something like that. I don't know, Sean Tumblr, that's a crazy program like that. I believe that is a strong way to think about how to structurally create an OC. Now, this is meant to be for the people making a new character from ground up. In this case, ethereal plane down, because it's all I'm sorry, I'm just dying, but it's all my name. And it's great because it highlights the fact that your choices you make really help feed into the other choices you have as well. It helps make your other choices stronger and it gives you good foundation for things. So we're going to go and break down this general process, We're going to start off with set. Could a pony or actor or anybody, really, this goes for OC, that, you know, you could have for anything. It doesn't have to be ponies, it doesn't have to be an anime, whatever. You need characters in general, just characters in general. It starts with the setting. Where does it live? Where does this story happen? Because you're not just creating a character, forming a story as well. If it's a pony, it could live in just Equestria as we know. It could be Ponyville, it could be Camelot, it could be some other random busting city like Manhattan, or some far off distant land. You remember that one that was on an island in the sky, way off, and she got blown off over to Equestria?
Yeah.
And so cool. It was in the cloud. It was like Galapagos Island.
Galapagos, I think it was.
God, I'm such a sucker for good fortune. Hey, guys, who can tell me what the horse point is for the town we're in right now? It could be something that's already been defined in the normal ending of the show, or it could be something that is in the alternate universe. Where they said that they may have skewed this one thing, but maybe it's not getting to that one thing. Literally the season 5 finale, which, by the way, a storm right there. Oh my god.
Oh man. I'm really surprised we didn't see a lot of those from that, because, oh my goodness, it is right with them.
So good. I think that's the closest we're going to get to, like, an actual fall out of the question. Oh, right, well, Sporty Kevin fall out of the question, because people are like, oh my god, fall out of the question, that's the thing I'm going to do, I hate my life, because I don't like anything, that doesn't make me sad,
But they haven't even played the original parts.
Yeah, I have figures. Yeah, but you didn't write one. You did, great. Some are not bad. I've said it. I don't care. Sorry for killing me. You shut up. How dare you? This person's name is Black Jack. She's my own wife. Anyways. Next slide, please. So, next, after you find out where your pony lives, you gotta find out what kind of race your pony is. I'm looking at this. That's a big old list. We've received all of those.
Oh, God.
We've received. all of those.
No, I'm talking about like this weird, like there's that one Pokemon that like has that, it's like a giraffe looking thing on the back end. So I'm talking like take this thing from like a Brawno plan from like Super Mario Bros. Or like. And that's the tail. Like this giant butt plant thing. And I don't know, butt plant is my name for it. It's actually like some, hey, if you spend 400 points on DeviantArt, you can be a part of a closed species and ask details. I'm like, 400, that's like what, 4 cents?
$4.
Yeah. What is a point? You want money!
What's the point?
Thank you, guys, for your all here. Yeah, next. Battle lines, race scissors.
Next.
Race scissors, and save scissors, but they're not good. Actually, you gotta talk about for a second. You gotta talk about how your character feels, how it does things. It's like it should be a diverse and complicated as you are as an individual. It should be special and cool. I love what I put on there. How Tumblr do you want to get it?
Very sexuality.
Yeah, exactly. Very sexuality, very inferior. What do you got?
No. This is like one of the most difficult parts of character creation, and it's very on the list of like mine.
Because this also feeds into literally everything you're going to do. Setting also feeds into everything else. The race feeds into everything else. Because obviously, if you have your setting as a pony going to live in Cloudville, you can't make it work.
Great.
It's called gravity, not racism, you putz. Anyway, I gotta figure out, like, not having fun. I'm going back to getting myself out of pocket. So, it's one of those things. She's magical. I said her at 20 years, ponies don't have magic. Shut up. Anyway, so. Whose paddle is it?
Mine.
Anyway, so. They're also, like, yeah, you can make with different sexuality fears. There's a great thing, what's the, Myers-Briggs, right? That's that thing.
Yeah, the Myers-Briggs, you are asked several many questions, and every little thing, differentiates whether you are, for the ISTJ / ENFP, it's, you're either an I or an E, introvert or extrovert. S or N, sensing and intuitive. T and F are thinking and feeling, and J or P, judging or perceiving.
It's like,
I wonder what all of us got for that last one. It's judging.
All four of us on the show, all together. Yeah, it's like a BuzzFeed quiz from like the 70s. It's like, hey, you're in this situation. What would you rather do? Would you rather look out the window and contemplate life? Or would you like to go drink with your friends? Oh, guess what? You're ENFP. Post to Facebook. Hey, guys, I got ENFP. What'd you get? Oh, man, Rebecca, I got IFPJ. What? That's weird.
We can't be friends.
You can't be friends. You're a Sagittarius, and I'm a Scorpio. You know, stars tell you who you can and can't be. Anyway, sorry, moving on. You can also do a thing online that's an actual literal Mary Sue test. It is like 500 questions, and it can easily determine like whether or not your character is Mary Sue or not. It's like, do they have powers in this world that are not available, or her power, or the character's powers are greater than the ability of other characters in the same said universe? Yes? No. If you mean yes, stop. That means it's overpowered. OP, nerf next match. Why is this nerf? Alright. And that leads me to interest. Now, this isn't special talent.
This is not the team mark.
This is not what their job is. I'm probably going to lose the mic a lot. I've got a double full soda. Go get rid of it.
It's gonna get real. It's interesting.
That's why you're the editor. Anyway, so, like I said, it's not a special talent. It's a small other thing that pony is like. Like, Pete, how much to make? A little more refined part of her personality, or what it likes. Don't forget about setting, race, or anything you want. And that, like I said, feeds into this. Next slide, please. You have your theme. This is the overall general idea of the character. It's something that's like a little bit more amalgamous than good or evil. There's something. It's more broad than personality, but not as crazy and amalgamous like good or evil. This is something that's really hard to define, and I'm personally a little bit confused about this because I'm basing this a lot off that first draft. So, if you have questions about theme, go ask Lisa again. Ask Craig for someone else. Next, you have your talent. This is the job of the character does for you. This is
the story of the predator running down the road.
Sorry, this is talent. So it's a job or whatever that your pony does. This is like not surely how she's more than just for love position. It's what your it's what makes your cutie mark. No, I didn't say that the cutie mark makes the talent. No. The talent makes the cutie mark. I've seen two new ponies out there that sit there and go, yeah, this is my OC, this is what it looks like. Fully colored, fully figured out, everything. That's the cutie mark. Man, that cutie mark's so cool. What's the talent? I didn't hear that yet. You are putting the cart before the horse at this point, guys. Come on. Talent, the size, the cutie mark, and don't you dare reference that horse. You ruined literally everything. Okay, so anyway, like I said, this is what makes the human life. This is colors. You guys want to find out about color theory and all that? Right? Colors. You want to learn about those, right? Go take a semester at college on colors, because that's great, but barely scratching the surface on color theory. Artists out there are like super confused about, I don't know how I'm going to put colors together, what colors mean, and further about characters. And people are like, oh yeah, green and purple means evil. And I'm like,
or without having to take a semester at a college or something, we could go to the CACQ Arts Crusaders and they've done
episodes
on colors. Yeah, but specifically they did one on color theory itself and then at least one on specified colors. I know they did a purple episode, I'm not sure if they did the other colors, so.
This is literally everything she does. Because it's close to you guys think about me and what you said. You guys have been thinking about it. What is the topic of it? Where do you live? What is the most person that works to you? What is the challenge? With everything else that we have that's going to be today, I have a pretty good question. What's maybe something, when I say Baker, what's something that comes to your head?
Breaking Bad.
I say smooth.
Down on your album.
Don't do it. I need a thing. A not person. Okay, yeah, donuts. All right, great. What is the part of the audience is here dying for some participation? Actually, I should be talking to you about it. What is one thing you think of when you think of donuts?
Sprinkles!
Eclair. Good. Fantastic. So, Eclair. Why did I have stacks of paper? What is something other than donuts that you think I would need to go baking?
Muffins!
Bread!
Cupcakes!
Cake!
Flour!
Muffins!
What is something you think of when you think of bread?
A roll.
Toasty Claire. That's your pony's name.
Yes.
Toasty Claire. You can actually use that. A baker. Okay, so we got a baker pony, we need a baker, we need a candlestick maker, and
the butcher, the baker, and the candlestick maker.
It's only my second Baja Blast, okay? Anyway, okay. I'm on like 2 hours of sleep at this point. So yeah, it's literally every other two characters. So what I was trying to show you with that whole main thing, if you want to take what I used to do in improv, if you're hearing a suggestion of a baker, think of something and then think of one thing further than that. And then bring it back and do that way. And I find that's a great way to come up with things. So try it yourself at home. Okay, so cutie mark. This is very important. You gotta think of the theme, the talent, and the colors. The theme, where, what it does, who it is, an amalgamation of what it is, but not from this good and evil. Don't pick any of
them.
So theme, talent, colors, and then talent is like what it is, what it likes to do, what your pony does, and colors. You gotta think about what a key mark would look good in your pony. You got like a solid, like nice, mellow, laid back, easy, warm color. That looks like beige. Like, you took the palette of this and then all this like blondish, sandy kind of stuff. But like, yeah. That's what I want. I want my pony to just a nice soft. I mean, yeah, cute mark. Neon pink.
Wow.
Don't do that. You gotta like think about colors in general. Like, if you had the tail color would be walls, and the tail color was like the red, like solid area of this carpet. Not the cool pattern customization. Actually, that would be a good idea. And then you make cute mark like one of those squares, but you don't do that, those squares you have to do. But like something like that, or like a vine pattern. Like, you notice how like you vine the like, very briefly off the walls? That's good, like, you have to do something like that. You guys can put it through here. I've been on 6 planes in the last 10 years. That's good. Anyway, so, you gotta find out what fits in that color. And keep it together. Don't go too crazy out there. If you've got like a green OC, you can make a blue cutie mark. I don't know what the title is, but you can do anything. But try to do something like that and make it special, you know? 3 colors max, and never, ever, ever use black outlines. Then it looks like what?
It's like a sticker you can just peel off their butt.
Oh, by the way, she's a rage, everybody!
Anyway, we've learned enough about cutie marks.
So you put it all together with some great art. You go out and say, yeah, I can draw these things. Yeah, I can definitely draw these things. Yeah, I'm going to draw these things. And then you realize, I grew. Don't ever say I can't draw because I know every one of you probably is able to do like that. So, good. But what? That's the same thing in drawing. But you're drawing letters. You could draw.
I'm a terrible dancer.
Don't lie to yourself. You can draw.
I can't read
my hand. I can't read mine, but look at me. Okay, so hand drawn is always fun. I'm so rude to you, I'm so sorry. I'm a disgusting individual. I'm really rude. So I think we're going to come back.
Water!
I think we're going to come back with like eight of those little tiny like doctor's cups. Like, right here. Now I will do Ave Maria while drinking water. So go out and find your one, make that drawing. And it's like, okay, you know what? I'm confident with my drawing ability, but you know what? I don't know if this is going to look even better. You know what I'm going to do? I'm going to commission somebody to draw this drawing. That is a smart move, my business. You know what I mean? Oh, they need. It's not
No Brosky.
The Brosky?
No Brosky.
Brosky Solomon?
Brosky Solomon.
Go to your lane? The proletariat and the sick bro, Kai's bro.
The bro, get back on topic.
Back in the USS, bro. Okay, so yeah, like, we got everything. Put it together in the final five. We got good art. Go out, commission somebody who you like. Somebody who artist, who part of you. Next slide. This is why I should never have a panel at 10 a.m. I'm angry right now. I'm not sure why my head is.
Name places is no way to go.
Anyway, so once you have everything figured out, you've got a great OC. You listen to everything I've said this entire day, even if I talk about something. Send it to us. Send it to us at
Also, I think only one of us can be signed in at the same time. Whereas all of us can look at the DeviantArt at any time on any of our accounts.
Because it's public. You can even see all the OCs that we have on our DeviantArt account today. You can go to our Facebook to look at the OCs and look at all the OCs that we have. You can even be a lesser. Too many. That's 24 pages for the OCs per page. That's 20 times 24.
That's 24 too many.
That's terrible.
That's already one episode. Further than where we would be at if we did an episode. So, yeah, actually, no, because we could do 2 episodes almost per page of the meeting. So,
that's
three. Yeah. That's three. Man. That's good. Anyway, next slide. Send it to us. So, we're actually not going to do questions quite yet because Lou's actually seeing a few things for the first time earlier Friday. So he took a comment about to create an OC. We're going to talk about that for just a second. So he followed these rules and he decided to show the things of his number. Doors and shadows?
Hmm?
Doors and homes?
What?
Or just more labor?
Just mine. Okay. I mean,
this thing is like 95% done by me. The only thing not done by me was the coloration, which was suggested by Citro 360 himself!
Okay, so,
okay, so to help you guys understand, I'm going to take your prefaces real quick and I'm going to show you what's going on right here. So tell us all about this thing.
This is probably a really bad time to say all the information from
the other side of the page.
Oh, where it goes to me. Spoilers. Come on, man. TLDR, hurry up, we're all in bad time.
TLDR, her name is Colorfill. She is a painter, but not a painter. She lives in Ponyville. Her parents were artists who didn't get a lot of money or weren't very popular artists. She's a disheveled person because she grew up with artists who are like, hey, you know, you be free, do what you want, and creativity and everything awesome. And she didn't really affluent family at all in the slightest. They were kind of really poor. And then one day she saw that other families could have a lot of income by having stable jobs and stuff like that. And she was just like,
wait, hold on.
Stable job?
She doesn't really agree with the parents much anymore, but she tries to generally be fun-loving-ish, but more realistic about everything. When she goes to her job as a part of a construction firm sort of thing, she paints houses. She doesn't paint pictures, she paints houses and stuff.
Wait, she paints houses?
I get it.
Paint is an actual breed of horse, everybody.
Yep.
And you call yourself equestrian.
It's a pony, not a horse.
Smooth, continue on before you kill me in the mob.
Anyway.
I lost where I was.
I lost where I was.
Paints, paint
paints, things.
Okay, look, it's too good. He's not at this con, he's just wearing a top hat and glasses, and I'm like, go on.
So yeah, when she's at the job, she focuses on the job, gets it done, moves on with life. She makes more money than her parents do.
Something we wish we all could do.
Yeah. She's not heartless, she just doesn't agree with them.
Ooh, so the personality, then, she's not heartless?
She just doesn't understand them at all, in the slightest. Yeah. Has a little trouble empathizing with them.
Clearly somebody who's watching the reason. Okay, sweet. Thank you very much, Moon, for telling us all about this. I think that was a good story.
You think it was a good story? Fine.
You made it in 8 days. It was good enough for an 8 day story. I was in a story people made up on the spot and it was terrible. I was in a story people said, oh yeah, I've been working on it for probably over a year. And I'm like, do you? Oh. Your backstory is smaller than a short answer. That's what I'm test. On my test, I would put yes, because reasons.
I was
fired. Yeah, because I am. Thank you, friend. Anyway, that's very nice of me. I really liked that backstory. So the amount of time I know that went into it, because I didn't just Friday whenever I get into you and I have no idea what the hell you're doing. Anyway, that's cool. That's pretty solid. I also like those colors. It is a nice soft blue and a nice soft yellow as well, with a nice pink highlight in the eye, as well as a pink mark that means groups.
Also, reusing colors from the eyes and cutie mark is
pretty legit. Thank you very much, Smith, for actually.
Yeah. He's good.
Yeah.
Speaking
of, I like to start talking to him. It's like part of her where someone drinking coffee and giving their paintbrush and the water and really drinking. And then they realize that their coffee is a little bit more green than I'm just Anyway, so great, wonderful. That was our close scene, and unfortunately, we have to cut that cut into our actual Q&A time. But I have a lot of great, and of course, we get to actually leave 5 minutes. That means that that still took up the same amount of time. I'm just a terrible presenter. Okay, so if you remember earlier on that PowerPoint, that's what they call these things. That shoulder hair is in the highest. I did not! Mr. McCracken, send him to the principal's office and have him expelled!
Who's passing this?
I didn't even know that was Shark going long ago. Back on topic, great! Right now, we're moving into the question and answer portion. I have the questions, you have the answers!
Wait,
you have the questions, we probably have half the answers that we'll be like, yeah, he answered it.
You have questions? We have questions? No one's getting answers.
We gotta get Neil deGrasse Tyson in here and be like, oh, you see, science will prove all of this. We'll be like, sure thing, Neil.
Science.
Okay, so the whole deal with these Q&As is the fact that I bought 2 years ago a so, my loss is your game. Ask a question, get a sticker. Ask an awesome question, get a mystery prize.
I got a question.
Questions, by the way, I hate putting your hands up. I have to do that. That's what.
But that's organization mummified.
That's what the baby boomers did. We're millennials, so we like to do things differently. Put a random object in here. That way you'd be like, foot, hat, plushie. Why did you have that? Put that away. There's not actually something there. I'm just thinking. I'm going to call on you for last, just to make you keep that up. Also, I like to go left, I like to go right, so if I ask the question to the right side, it turns out I'm going to go left next turn, so you might as well put your hand down. So, saying that, let's start with the right side. Smooth, who do you want to call on?
I'm not wearing my glasses, so I can't see anything.
Smooth, you want to call on the person with the NESDS, right?
Yes, you do, Mummified. You say NESDS you want to.
Plus 348, starring Knuckles and Dante from the Zelda Christ here. What do you guys, yes?
I kind of wanted to ask a question, kind of a hypothetical question.
Okay, so we're actually, the hypothetical Q&A is after the regular Q&A. What's your hypothetical too?
Well, I was asking, I have an OC who's a story setting personality who's gotten a bit confused the last few years, and I'm kind of curious if I should salvage it or if I should throw it out and start over.
Okay, so confusing backstories are a thing that happens because people get too much inside their own book. Let me ask you my question, guys. Can you first get through the video? You got both the other ones. I'm firing the lungs. Sorry, so, confusing backstories can be terrible. I hate the way it's like, yeah, I'm going to be over here with my story. And then, oh, yeah, there's also this other thing over here. And then, like, there's finally a TLDR version of the bottom that's like, what's happened? And I'm like, you're. not working it right. So, like, how would you do this? Do you think that a confusing backstory is so far gone it can't be solved if you just scrap it?
You can scrap it and try again. Like, generally use the same thematic elements, but do it better.
Yeah, you take those themes and ideas from your confusing and off the wall story, and boil it down and be like, okay, what am I trying to convey with this? In a thousand words or less, what is my story trying to do? Okay. Four. Not interesting.
What's the game? I'll have a new message.
Alright, see, what up? Oh, by the way, you get a sticker.
Real sticker.
So while he's coming up, you get a sticker. And feet, what do you got?
I was just taking back the story too much, but I feel like the media was around us that was getting the story.
And who? Oh, the phone's for.
When the wind.
Oh, when we put it in the phone. There's somebody. There was actually somebody.
Yes, yeah, someone.
Oh, that was you?
Why?
Because I agree with you.
Damage.
We don't care that much.
Why
do you?
Why does that matter?
Unemployment is a curse. It's a gift. Anyway, yeah, so thank you very much for keeping score on whatever. It clearly shows that Commander is kicking out butt. And you are really bad at that.
I have, like, what was it, the fewest or the fewest next to Solar?
You got one. Yeah, Solar, you have come on like 3/4 of the way through the show and is never around. You have close to him. You have half the normal amount of wins.
In the bad category. In the good category, I'm winning. So get on my level.
Thank you very much, Pete. Thank you for that question. You get a sticker as opposed to that guy who has a hypothetical question, so he got a hypothetical sticker. Okay, so we're on this side now. Let's hit you don't want to post copy that.
What's your chance on
lowering the set? So, they're good. They are great. My OC is a unicorn white, with a very cool eye, and wears a like vest suit thing because full sleeves look weird on my knees. Long shirt with cufflinks that should keep you marked. We love you to tie and be becoming the whole character together is quite fun. But if you're like trying to make a like Kingdom Hearts with like belts and Japanese on it and it's just belts everywhere, the Japanese anime belts, it's like accessories.
Giant zipper.
Clothing is great on this thing, but it really helps make it feel unique and personal. As opposed to just some random thing you find in the color creator. By the way, they say this. Never use any creator as a kind of product, always use one of those things. You get a sticker. If that goes to the map. This side, tell you what, you're blocking her views. The jam's more backpack. What is the question?
I'm on, like, I think that's episode 19.
Of our show?
Yes. And I want to know. No.
Okay. We get better in the sense of we know how to be as an OC show, so it gets better in that sense. Quality? No, we're kind of saying the same. Actually, quality toward the end actually kind of goes down because we put like minimal effort into it.
Watch all the episodes with Soren in them because those are funny. I hate editing them because the track is not existent.
Yeah, that was like the first 5 episodes. Mm-hmm. I was sitting at the time with my descendants, C1, whatever. And then actual reviews, what's the casual thing, what's that? I started off just using a game headset. That's not that. That was wrong. And then I finished with Blue Yeti Snowball. And then after that, I got my Samsung C1. And I'm like, wait, C1, C01U. That's the same one! Oh my god, me and Jan, you the same one you have right now! Oh my god!
I've just been using the same one that I bought at Best Buy like 3 years ago.
Yeah, the man has gone through like two of them. He's gone through just the one and doesn't have it.
Well, I mean, it's the same kind every single time. It's a different microphone. I just keep buying the same product.
Oh, okay. Great, fantastic. And we move to the second. First of all, we're going to be. Oops, I always go so person that we analyst comments since yeah too. That I am never a part of. Can we talk about that for a second? Are we not a part of the analyst community? Should we not analyze things involving the show? We're analysts, right?
Yeah. Technically.
I talked to him like 3 times. I'm like, dude, whoa. How do I get in the analyst community? I post on r/MLP analysis up until like episode 30, and then I'm like, what's the point? And I'm like, yeah, people are like, here's a picture of all the analysis ponies. And I'm like, who is that? Literally who? I don't recognize. Oh god, whose OC is that? I don't know. And yet.
Yeah. Sometimes they do include us, actually.
No? Wait, there was that one that had Mando Pony on it, and Sydney, and it was like just the cool runnies?
Yeah. Why were we on?
Anyway, sorry. My own business at the site. What is your question? Actually, there was a great class in machine college called ESL1. It was really a special system. Personally, I have skill experience in improv comedy. I actually was at improv for like 5 years, like 1 year. And then about, when at one point, I was helping out, they were doing 5 shows a weekend. And I'm like, this is good. I'd be sitting there, I'd be like, okay. I'd be sitting there like doing the second team's like Thursday special show, and then I'd be how I'd be performing either on one of the two Friday shows or also performing on one of the Saturday shows or the special midnight. Like, not all we do is after dark show or helping out backstage with the lights and stuff after that. At one point I could have been doing 5 shows a weekend and I'm like, all right, yeah, improv. You've taught me so much that like saying yes. And by the way, Paul Giamatti is not being yes and in that commercial. Yes and is saying yes, you do have brown hair, and I think it looks good, not yes, and that is sandbagging your partner. That's not improv. That's wrong. What about you? How do you want to do this?
Good answer!
One of the things in fact that is in PS on the show a lot, we learn how to do PS because of the fact that
sometimes it's sick.
Sometimes we record for 3 hours. And it gets cut and you make it like that. Yeah. So it's just also getting to know your partners. Being able to know that if I go, yeah, smooth, like what do you think of the clothes on this one? You're gonna be like,
colors are like, they're not bad, it's just that something about it just doesn't resonate with me.
Yeah, it's just one of those things that we can learn how to do, and that was a great question. Guess what? You get one of the mystery prizes. What did you get?
Well, if you look over here, you'll see it is a YOCS Sucks poster!
You just left over from Babs Con. 2015. And when we started to walk, by the way, my good friend Hardcover from KPNY show a part of the Everfree Network.
The press and
Chris. Press and Chris. Press and Chris. Fun Chris.
Just like another thing about raise your DS and raise your videos and projects like that. I also was thinking an audio drama, but really it's most, yes, exactly. It was a radio audio drama type thing, and you get better as you go along. The more you do it, the better you'll get. Like you'll do more, you'll realize what works and what doesn't, and eventually you'll also just get to where it can be passable, like DC. Like, we'll start off weird, and we recorded the first season of our show, like, three times before we actually aired it. And this is recorded, edited, listened, re-recorded, edited, listened, bought new microphones, and turned out we needed to do better microphones, re-recorded, and that's what we got.
There's a lot of things that go into podcast production, and after doing it for a while, you learn how to really actually become a you learn how to like come to the industry that you want to mm-hmm. whatever medium you're going to do. So thank you very much for that.
It is
an awesome insight. Okay, we're gonna try to make these questions a little bit faster because we're not running a long time. Left side, let's go with Pirate.
But this kind of crossing into series, don't
you? Crossing into series, like.
Don't do it ever.
Like, so dumb with her. It's like, oh, YOCS has been through a find his way into Equestria. What happens next? I'm like, why?
Why?
No. There's a video series out there where it's like, Batman in Ponyville, Elsa in Ponyville, whatever. I'm like, want to write it. But it's like, one of those things that I'm like, yeah, crossover thing can happen. But I don't care. Those scenes that you say, well, it's supposed to be this character from a video game or this pure anime that I don't watch because I'm not a massive weeb. And whatever, blah, 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 yada, yada, yada. I'm supposed to do this. I'm like, dude, I don't get the source material. So I have no basis for it either. I know ponies. You made a pony from whatever show. The pony looks weird and dumb. I don't get it. Well, that's because of this. Okay, so why are you talking to me? I have no point to this. Now if you're like, oh man, it's another thing that you get, I'd be like, oh, like I'm getting this, this, and this. We're all here, and I know if I went out to eat one of them, and like, ha, ponies, right? You're gonna be like, yeah, ponies. But if I go out to them, I'm like, man, Tenshi and Ryoko's relationship is such like a weird thing, right? I'm so much more of an Aika Tenshi kind of guy, man, right?
Yeah.
What? Excuse me. The what?
Tenshi Muyo and Tenshi Universe were fine. Tokyo was weird and GPS was
But man, that Simpo here.
Anyway, but it's like you're gonna have to sit there and understand both concepts and both concepts that's happening. And they're really enjoying it. So just keep that in mind. Hey, who's on next? You know? Hey, Andy guy, who's got the next panel?
Is it? Oh, hey, how about like 15 more questions?
Yeah, the true Lopez, right? Wolf King. Back to the forest, right?
If you want to walk to the woods with the DF to arrows, then you might not be able to race you on. That's an idea of something that
I have to do.
I don't want to talk. I don't want to talk. He seems like a nice guy. We're at 58. So I can do another one, I guess. That's fine. You're not right about it. Mm-hmm. Tell you what. You know what, Pine Tree, you've been on your head and follow me.
Do you think it's so good to have your own, like, DHT titles and just get, but not be like, super, oh my god, I'm so special, my mom's like, no, but like, make it more like, obviously, like, I don't want people to know about DHT titles.
So
up, Mummified? What's your opinion on that?
Okay, making characters that are next generation only for the person finally matter. But I was fine with it until you said, "I just don't really want people to know about it because they're following the pretty good." Then what's the point at that point? Like, I also didn't follow anybody who does that, or if they have a storyline that is, yeah, they're the daughter of Fluttershy and Discord, but they're, you know, they don't like talking about them because they're not that great. One, oh my god, what kind of relationship does that parent have with their child where they're just like, oh, we don't like talking about them? They have a child, that is your creation, you're just gonna sleep among their mug? Who are they, Harry Potter? And so then it goes into, okay, are you creating this character for to just make a weird ship character, which is fine, it's okay, but make sure that it's not a one-trick pony, it's not the fact that it is just the next generation. So I'm going to look into who I love this woman. I know tomorrow.
Why did you do it?
I love her so much. Chihuahua 97 has an entire back catalog of OCs that are like actually two generations deep from the main six and other characters as well. It's so good. And even her girlfriend, Rocket, like her own generation, afterwards, and there's like crack ships that says, oh yeah, Discord and Twilight has it. And then there's one over here that's like, okay, well, what is, like, Great of Dash and Celestia has a kid. It's weird. Genetically, it doesn't make sense, but it's like, oh man, that creates a
cool. Olympian ball.
Yeah, it's weird. I'm not. Anyway.
Flash Sentry and Brayburn.
Hey, Amy, guy. Mark, could you put me a hand signal when I missed for anything? What? Did you.
Huh?
Just give me a hand signal for you to tell me the name time. Yeah, that time. Great. I was only asking because
like we do in a.
That job.
That job. Okay. Well, thank you everybody for coming out to the show. I want to real quick. We have a Patreon. Go to patreon.com.
Don't do it.
Thanks, everybody. Enjoy the rest of the con.
I wouldn't have to.
Feel free to take your name tags and everything, those are all yours.
Thank you very much, man.
Yep.
Yeah, sure. You don't. Unless they come to you and say, hey, what do you think of my OC? You don't. That's something that it's one of those things that it's like, yeah. You'd be like, yeah, I like your OC. There's just something that I could nitpick a little bit about and could be improved. So it's all about being tactful. It's all about being like respectful to the fact that this was a work of art that they worked on and that it's a thing that